All right, time now for the metal rock edition of the Water Cooler Buzz and Why Not? Fourth annual Sunset Strip Music Festival in high gear. But how did music and partying become such an instrumental part of the Sunset Strip? Our special guest knows all. His name is Willie Bass, the former frontman of the legendary LA rock band Black Sheep. I love this line. They're quoting you. Three bands, three kegs, and 1,000 people.
Sounds like a good time.
Was every party like that?
Is that the appropriate equation?
Well, that was it back in the day. Absolutely.
And you survived it.
Like, that's the thing he said.
Yeah. You look good.
You look real good.
You should not look so good.
Thank you.
Your eyes are clear.
Slash says, hanging with Willie and Black Sheep was, quote, a rite of passage.
Yes.
So when you saw these people kind of pass through whatever portal you provided, did the talented ones make it, or who made it?
Well, do you have to be at the right place at the right time with the goods to deliver, you know? It's more about who you know, and the Sunset Strip is legendary in that it's an icon within itself, because you had, like, Otis Redding, the Temptations played the Whiskey, and then you had, like, Jimi Hendrix.
Yeah.
You know, the Doors, that era. Then you had Van Halen, Motley Crue, Black Sheep, Guns N' Roses. You know, it just evolved and evolved. And I just did a fundraiser there a couple of weeks ago for leukemia research, because Vince Neil's daughter, Skylar Neil, passed away of leukemia. So we got involved. We did a big fundraiser, and that was a great, great event.
Well, those venues, and I tell you what, I think artists must feel it as well. When you're on the stage at the Roxy, or you're on the stage at the Whiskey, you know, and on one level, frankly, it's just this, you know, crummy piece of wood. On another level, it's like the most historic stages you can imagine.
Absolutely. Well, when you're there, you don't really take all of that into account. I mean, I have photos of my daughter, Amber, standing at the stage, and she's not even as tall as the stage, and she's 27 now. So it's just amazing. It's amazing. I mean, I played the Troubadour when Doug Weston booked the bands himself.
Oh, wow.
So, I'm just very, very grateful to be a part and to have come along when I came along.
When you look back, though, I know that as I get older, I have a tendency to do a little bit of revisionist history. I make the golden years look even more golden. You know, looking back, do you find that what we talk about of that era is the same as what you experienced in that era?
Sometimes, yes, absolutely. You know, it's always... we used to go out with the passion. We would poster every pole in Hollywood, just out of the sheer desire to have a great show and pack the clubs. Yeah. You know, I was out there with Axl Rose putting up posters.
How about that?
And we would come back to the studio, you know, because Guns N' Roses started at my studio. Sure. So it was a great, great time, great experience. And like I said, we just really cared about the music and putting on a great show.
You just got together with the legendary Led Zeppelin producer, Andy Johns, to produce a new single called Breakaway. So the music's still obviously, there it is.
There it is.
Voila. It obviously still, it's always in you. I mean, I can't imagine.
Oh, I said that to my marketing guy the other day. I was like, you know, man, I still believe.
Good for you.
You might think I'm nuts, but I still believe.
No, not at all.
Do you like the new world of everything being on the internet, iPods, downloads, and that?
Oh,
or do you prefer? You do
love
like
it.
The technology.
I embrace that immediately because it puts me directly in touch with my fans.
Yeah.
You know, I don't have to filter through a publicist, or, you know, I can just get online, tweet, or do whatever I need to do.
Listen,
and they're hearing it from the horse's mouth.
Wow.
Or, you know what, his own website, Willie Willie Bassie, BASSE.com.
Bass.
Willie Bass, of course.
As in.
With the E for spelling sake. Willie, nice to see you.
A legend of Sunset Strip sitting right here with us.
By the way, super duper mega coverage of our
Sunset Strip.
Our newscast on Saturday night expanded.
Really?
For like 3 hours to take it all in.
How about that?
So there you go.
Wow, great.
All right, Willie, what a pleasure to have you here today.
Thank you so much.
Thanks so much for sharing some of those stories.